everybody. Been a while since we posted and did a video. I actually lost all my video equipment, believe it or not. But we're here now, so let you ride along a little bit. We're heading over here, pick up this 336 for a customer. They my main customer now, and really good people, very loyal. Pay my bills, and can't ask for more. But they use this machine to test holes when they have a job they want to bid, and to test the ground, see what they're getting into, so they can place a bid on what materials and etc. they'll need. So we're going in here. I dropped this thing off yesterday. It's a little narrow road. Let you ride along and see what happens when we get down there. This road right here is Hamilton Pool. It used to be a little country road. Past, I don't know, 5-10 years. Obviously people moved here. It's just exploded. It used to not be this busy. This neighborhood we're going to is fairly new. Way out there, as they would say. I think they're fixing to make it a 4-lane road, which is why you see them do all the groundwork, all the utilities right now. Pretty narrow. I usually take my time coming through here with a 336 because we'll be hanging off. I already ordered my permit, and they permitted me all the way to the road that we're coming out on from the subdivision, so not too difficult. But we're going to go from here. We're on the northwest side of Austin. We're going to go around back through Oak Hill, kind of through the middle of Austin, and then up through Mopac, and then over to 35 and up in the north, way north Austin, a little town called Gerald. Well, it's small now, but it won't be in a little while. It's about 30 miles north of Austin. So it's a nice little ride. probably $500,000 houses starting. They sell usually before they're built. A nice pool. I think there's a golf course in here somewhere. Yesterday there was two other machines sitting here. Let's see what there is today. So usually I would turn around back up there and just back down this road and then load off the rear. Or on the rear, like straight up into that hole right there. But you'll see here in a second, I came through yesterday, and there's a dive off I can cut around, turn around in, and then I'll back up right here. Here and ran over these water meters. I don't know if y'all can see them on the video or not. That's nice of them. I suspect it's the other test hole machine from the other company. But we'll go around and we won't do that. Other people can't, and that's why we usually get to do the test hole machines, because they're tight, they don't have much room for a truck and trailer to detach and unload. Obviously we can just unload, drop it right there on the spot, and they can go off into the trees, whatever they gotta do. So they went all up in there, dug a bunch of holes. Stop here and get back there and open the valve to do the trailer. Switch in here. The valve right there. It won't do it while I'm standing here. By the time I get over there and get back in, it will.
All right, got all chains and binders ready. Put down rubber on both sides. So when the machine comes over the rear and lands on the rubber, it doesn't totally mess up the deck. That's a trick I learned after messing up the deck some. Well, looks like somebody's trying to get out, so I'm gonna make this quick. Loaded. I moved out of the way of that guy. All chained down. All right, here's our route. I don't know how well you can see. There's where we're at. We'll be going down around Mopac, down 71, get to the Y, up Mopac. We'll do a little light moving around right here, get over to 35, and then all the way up to Gerald where we're going. I already got the permit, that's the way it went as well. So let's get going. Back on Hamilton Pole. You see it gets pretty narrow. Tracks are obviously wider than the road. So we'll just cruise through here, take our time. Don't want to hit anything. More importantly, I don't want to hit anybody. I already got a line of cars behind me, but I don't really care. People around here get mad about it. Slow, too fast, left lane, right lane, it doesn't matter. Somebody's gonna get pissed off, so always just do your thing. Be careful. And don't hurt anybody. Hamilton, pool on the 71, go through BK's, Lakeway. Just gonna have a lot of patience with going through little towns, like, not little, but just going through this part of Austin, pretty much any part of Austin, or any town. These people, they think they're in a hurry to get to Starbucks, and they'll cut you off, swerve around you, cut you off to turn. So, if you ever notice, when I'm driving through towns like this, I'll stay in the left lane. That way people can go up and down to the right. It makes people mad, but they've never driven anything bigger than their Prius, so that just kind of cuts down on the people cutting in front of you, jamming on their brakes to turn. If they do have to turn, they have a turn lane, and you can kind of go around them. Again, it's about safety. I used to get wound up about people, road rage, I guess. That was right. But it's just, it doesn't do anybody good. Just do your thing. I promise you, these people won't remember you by the end of the day. Let's see how much traffic we got out here. He's not any further than he was a minute ago, but that's all right. our day.
Sometimes you just get fucked. Cruising down the road, we're not even going that fast. Blows right out. I got y'all set up. Just look over my shoulder, kind of see what I'm doing. People are scared of these things, the way we load them. I'll just kind of tell you what I'm doing. Obviously, I'm sticking the boom out. I'm just gonna walk off the back of the trailer. Go slow, like with everything else. Pulling back, that boom comes in and the machine starts going down. Try not to tear up the dirt too much. There we go. I'll just walk off a little bit and then I'll spin around. Again. About right there. And I'll just keep walking back. Once the bucket hits the ground, I'll push it back out. Walks the machine right off the trailer. Stop. Raise the boom up. And we're off. Down, close the safety switch. Now get out, sweep the deck, clean everything off, and we'll be headed home.